有一位先生呢，要过60岁，请一个出家的师父回来诵经，来祈福祝寿了。
有一位先生呢，他60岁寿辰啦，就请一位出家人咧帮佢诵经祝福。
A particular person, one man who reaches the age of 60, has a birthday party and he invites a monk to say good things to him.
师父诵过经了，就问他：“你要我替你求寿，你要求多少啊？”
咁啊，诵完经之后，师父问佢：“你要我帮你求寿，你要求几多岁咧？”
After the sutras have been read, this monk asks the man.How many years do you want to have in your life?
他说我今年60岁啊。他说你替我求，再增加20岁，80岁就好了。
咁我今年呢60岁啦，你帮我求多20岁咧，到80岁就好了。
Now this man says I'm already 60. I need 20 more years.
啊，你现在已经到60岁了，再求20岁很快呀，马上就80岁了。哦，难道还可以增加吗？那也不算好吗？
咁啊，佢咧就个师傅就话啦，20岁好快过嘅啫喎。咁佢话：咦，唔通我要求多啲啊？100岁得唔得啊
？Well, the monk says 20 years is a very short time. You'll be soon 80. Would you ask for more?
求100岁也很快呀、啊，只有40年，60年都过去了，40年很快呀、啊。哎呦，师傅，难道真的可以120岁吗？
咁咧，师傅就讲啦，唉，你要多40岁，咁你60岁都咁快过咗咯，40岁好快过啫。咁佢话，咦，唔通我可以求120岁咩
？Well, the monk says, well, even if you ask for 40 more years, you die at the age of 100, and that comes around very quickly. Won't you ask for more, like 120?
这个法师说。120岁，只有一半呢、啊。你过了60岁了，啊，又要是一半呢、啊。应该要求无量寿。
师傅讲咧就话你60岁已经过咗啦。如果120岁咧，只不过咧系多一半啫。咁好快脆就过啦，应该求无量寿。
Well, the monk says you should be asking for long life, perpetual life.
假如你们各位。听到这里的话，要想自己知道将来究竟能可以活多少岁，我今年真实地告诉你们，人人都是无量寿的。
假如你听到呢度咧，你会问啦，我可以活到几多岁咧？讲俾你听，人人都可以活到无量寿。
If you want to ask me how long I can live, I want to tell you that everybody can live a limitless life.
人本来就不死啊。
人本來就係唔死嘅。
Human beings don't die to begin with.
死是躯壳、身體，生命是不死。
死係呢一個軀殼，生命係不死嘅。
Only the corporal body dies. Life doesn't die.
就是科學說吧，物質不滅，物質都能不滅，生命還能消失嗎？
好似科學講物質不滅，咁物質都不滅啦，生命又可以消失咩
？Science tells us that matter do not disappear. So if matter does not disappear, how can human life disappear?
这一杯水泼到桌子上，茶杯打坏了，茶杯恢复不可能。把这个水统统都弄拖把。抹布搅起来，存在一点都不少。
呢个杯水如果打烂咗咧，个杯咧就黐唔翻啦。但系啲水咧，如果揾块布咧，将佢索咧索埋咧，可以咧揸翻出嚟，一滴都唔少噶。
Well, if you break a cup containing water, you don't get the cup. But if you use a piece of cloth and soak up the water, you still get the water back.
我们的生命就好像这个念珠。今年张三李四天上人间，这个一粒一滴水的一段一段，生命的体不一样， 不过这个生命的这个动机是由于我们一个生命线的一个业，一个生命的，所以色啊，它把我们会存在一起，不会散失，就是不会灭亡的。
咁我哋嘅生命咧就好似一个念珠咁啊，一时张三李四，一时天堂地狱啦。但系我哋嘅业，我哋嘅意识咧就好似一条念珠咁，将呢个生命串埋一齐。
Our consciousness is like a string of beads linking together the various parts of our life.
有人问，不发长长，胡须很长的一个老公公，老公公，你今年几岁呢？老公公说：我四岁。
咁啊，有一位咧白发苍苍嘅老翁咧，咁咧人哋问佢：你几岁啊？佢话：我今年四岁。
There's an old man who says when people ask him that he is only 4 years old.
什么样子胡子那么长，头发都白了，怎么只有四岁呢？老公公说：他说我过去浪度了生命。是最近四年来啊，才懂得慈悲，懂得做人、义理、道德，才活出人生的意味来。所以你问我几岁，我就说我四岁。
咁我呢个又头发又白又长须嘅人咧，佢话咧，我过去咧浪荡生命啊，我而家咧懂得慈悲，懂得做人咧，咁先正咧喺呢四年间咧，觉得自己系呢有生命嘅人。
So the old man with white hair said, I've wasted all my past life except the last 4 years. In the past 4 years, I've learned to be merciful, to be kind, and so I have lived for the past 4 years.
可见这个生命呢，不是在形象上的这个多少长短，像中国的安徽也只是30岁。佛教的有一位叫做沈照大师，很有学问的，留下了很多的佛法，也是30岁。所以有志不在临高，这个人生是看他的做的这个做出来的意义和表现，倒并不在胡子白了、头发长了，不是那样。
咁啊，呢啲頭髮白啊、鬍鬚長呢，只不過係形象上邊嘅一個分別嚟嘅啫。譬如好多人啊，譬如中國有啲好著名嘅高僧大德啦，佢得30歲，但係咧佢個佛法係非常之高。
Well, a life is not calculated in terms of how long you have lived. There are some Buddhist masters who have lived for 30 years, but they know the Dharma very well, and so they have lived a good life.
佛教看我們每一個人。它是形容的，就是我们的真的这个另外一个生命的体是什么样呢？数穷三际，哄骗十法。
佛教咧睇我哋一个人嘅生命啊，从另一个角度嚟睇，就系数穷三际，横骗十方。
Well, Buddhism looks at life from a very different perspective.
就是我们的生命，用数的来讲，从过去到现在，现在到未来，无限的未来。